Hey, what's up guys, it's Kausub here and today we will be taking a look at the Lineage OS 14.1 and this is a Android 7.1 Nougat based ROM for the OnePlus 3T. So do watch the video till the end and as per the drill guys, make sure you hit that red subscribe button down below and also turn the notifications on so that you don't miss any of my upcoming videos. With that being said, let's roll the intro and let's get the video started. So firstly guys, as always, we'll be taking a look at the about info of this ROM, and this is the Sultan's Lineage OS 14.1 custom ROM, which is based upon Android Nougat 7.1 guys. So this is an old ROM I should say, but I got many requests to review this, so I'm doing it. So right now here I will just quickly go into the about info. So in about phone, if we go here, then we get all the stats. So the Android version, as I told you, it is Android version 7.1.2. So it's pretty old ROM, I should say, but then too, it's really good, I should say. Lineage OS version, if I show you, then this is the Lineage OS logo that we get. So Lineage OS version is version 14.1. Then Android security patch level is January 2020. So this is a old security patch, I should say, but at least it has been updated to 2020 January. So that's a nice thing. So thanks to the developer for updating that. Then kernel version is Sultan's kernel. So this is the main USP or the specialty of this ROM. This kernel is really good. So yeah, and the build date is Thursday, January 9, 2020. So this is the latest build which the developer has lastly updated on the forum. So that's about it for the about info. Secondly, coming to is the display and the ROM customizations. So here I will just go into display. In display, we get all the basic settings. Live display is present, so you can select the color profiles according to your need. So other than that, everything is bone stock. Like ambient display is also present. Always on display was not there at that time during Android 7.1. So we don't have always on display, but we have ambient display function here. Other than that, everything is self-explanatory, nothing special. And talking about ROM customizations guys, then there is nothing. Like you can see in the settings, we don't have any customizations here. Coming to the third thing guys, is the stock launcher that this ROM comes with. So this is the Trebuchet launcher which it has, and it is pretty basic. You can see all the icon styles, they look really AOSP sort of. They have this basic Android 7.1 kind of a vibe to it. It looks really good, like it is pretty minimal. In launcher settings, if we go here, then we get all the basic settings, home screen setting, drawer settings, and app settings. Nothing fancy is present. Again, if I go into the widgets here, you get all the access to all the app widgets that you have and wallpaper. So that's for the launcher. And also another thing I noticed is guys, the lag, is absolutely not there. I used to observe this lag a lot on Android 10 or Android 9 based custom ROMs. There used to be that minor lag, but in this one I didn't feel at all. Like it is way too smooth. Like it is what just like Oxygen OS, I should say. It is really smooth. The animations are really good in this ROM, so you will not notice any sort of lag which is present in Android 10 custom ROMs. Also, nextly, I will be talking about AnTuTu benchmarks. So benchmark scores have really impressed me. I was quite surprised to see this such an old ROM performing really well in AnTuTu benchmark. So you can see here, the scores are 230,632 guys, and this is the highest score which I've ever observed in my testing period. On all the ROMs which I've tested till now, this is the highest out of them all. So benchmark scores are really high, so judging by the benchmark scores, you can also have a brief idea as to how the gaming performance will be. It will be absolutely stellar. Further moving on in the video guys, I would like to talk about some of the issues which I faced with this ROM. So guys, this ROM is based upon actually Android 7.1 Nougat, and due to which the emoji pack that is offers is really an old emoji pack. So you get this old blob emoji pack here, and some of the latest emojis are missing from this, but you can also download any other emoji pack and flash it, but by default you get this one. So that's one issue. And due to this old emoji pack, what happens is that exactly if you have any apps which doesn't support this old emoji or a font pack, then you will basically get this sort of an issue. Like, as you can see, the name on my Instagram profile is showing in blocks completely because the text is not supported by this custom ROM. So that's one issue. Moving on to the next issue is with the VoLT and the network. So as you guys can see, I don't have the volt symbol on top because VoLT is not working on this ROM specifically. Talking about the next issue is with the security, guys. Then this ROM doesn't have any face unlock feature as well, so you will always have to use or rely on the fingerprint scanner. And if you go into the settings, guys, into smart lock here, then too you don't have any face unlock option because Google has removed face unlock from all the GApp packages. Next thing is the camera performance of this ROM, guys. Then by default you get this AOSP camera installed, and guys, this is not any basic AOSP camera. This camera has been very well tuned by the developer himself, so a lot of things have been said on the forum. We get by default HDR control, so that is present. You get a lot of features or parameters which you can change according to a need. Also, you get a lot of modes. Then too, guys, you can always go for Gcam mod. And guys, here you have to use the old Gcam mod version 5, guys. So this is the older Gcam. I will leave a link to this app in the description down below. You can download it if you want. So lastly, talking about is the battery life, guys. And battery life was the main reason why I tried out this ROM, because most of you guys were recommending me to try this ROM out because of the battery life. But guys, I was disappointed with it because battery life is average, like that of only Android 9 and Android 10 custom ROMs also provide similar sort of a battery life. The battery life average I was getting was around 4.5 hours of screen on time. You can see in the screenshot itself, some days I used to get 5 hours as well, but most of the times I was averaging around 4 to 4.5 hours. So that is the sort of battery life you will get out of this ROM. And talking about the battery menu itself, then here in the battery saver performance, we get a performance profiles. You can set it on balanced, performance, or power saver. So that's there. So finally, concluding the video, guys, I would like to mention a couple of steps which you need to follow if you are interested in flashing this ROM. So firstly, guys, you have to decrypt your device, so that's necessary. Second thing is to flash the old firmware, and thirdly, you have to flash the custom ROM with GApps. So these three steps are pretty basic. You have to follow them, and all the links will be given in the description down below. You can check it out. So finally, what I think about this ROM is that this is a really good ROM, I should say. And if you can live with the issues this has, like I have mentioned the issues previously, then you should definitely try this ROM out. Also, guys, the AnTuTu scores which I have seen, I have shown you guys, are really impressive for this ROM. This being really old ROM, then too, it has the highest AnTuTu scores I've ever seen. So and that has been achieved even after being an underclocked CPU based ROM. So CPU has been underclocked on this one, but then too, the performance is really stellar, I should say. I was really impressed. So yeah, so you can definitely try this ROM out if you want to. And if you guys are again confused which is the best ROM, then as always, my two ROM recommendations will be the SkyDragon OS, which is based upon Android Pi. You can check it here. And the second ROM is Eolution X 4.4, based upon Android 10. It is also here. You can check them out. So that's about it for this short and simple video. I hope you guys have liked this video, and if you like it, then please do hit the like button down below, and also do get subscribed to my channel for more awesome content. This is your boy Kaustubia from T2E signing off. You guys have a great day.